We tried prohibition. It was a complete disaster. So I don't think it's the role of government to tell everybody what they should do. And seatbelt laws, we really started with buzzers that nudge us to buckle up. And I think we can help people make better decisions without telling them what to do.
Well, explain to me one thing. You know, we heard Andrew Lansley say we're going to nudge people, not nanny them. What's the difference?
Well, the difference is that we're not going to pass laws saying you can't eat fast food, you can't do this, you can't do that.
But nobody's going to say do that, though, are they? Nobody's going to say you can't eat fast food.
Oh, of course.
Not as a law, you know, no more McDonald's hamburgers. Nobody's going to do that.
Well, there are many people trying to propose laws to ban this sort of food or that sort of food. And we have all kinds of laws on the books.
But you see, when I read your book, enjoyed it, very provocative, made
Thank
me
you.
Think, all good things. But then, you know, you start thinking, this is the sort of stuff that nannies and parents do. They say, eat your greens, you know, eat your crusts that make your hair curly, do the right thing at school, you get a star. Those are all nudges. That's what nannies do.
Yeah, but that's the difference. No, that's nannying. Nudging is making the spinach taste a little better. And the kids will like it better and will enjoy it.
But what, I mean, it is of limited value, isn't it? It's good that you get people to do good things. That's what religions do that. You know, it's a good thing for them to do that. But to get to achieve big things, you can't do it by nudging people, can you?
Well,
really big things.
No, I disagree. Take the environment. There are lots of little things we can do. If we are going to deal with climate change, it will be one small step at a time. I met with people today in the energy department who are trying to think about how to get people to insulate their lofts. You know, that in and of itself won't solve climate change or dependence on oil, but it will help. In America, we get on my bill, on my electric bill, I'm told how much my neighbors are spending. And if I see I'm out of line, I'll say, well, maybe I ought to cut down.
Well, if you see you're out of line and you're spending less than them, maybe you'll say, well, maybe I can spend a bit more. You know,
well,
it may nudge in the other direction.
Yeah, we can handle that too. We give them a little smiley face, and that's enough.
Well, do you think smiley faces will save the planet? I suppose that's really what I'm asking. Things like Clean Air Act, the big, giving women the vote. It wasn't a nudge, it was actually a law, finally, that people decided. The big things in life are decided by governments doing that, aren't they?
I'm not saying that we can accomplish everything with a nudge. The purpose of writing the book was to say, how far can we go without bans and mandates? We have laws against murder. I'm in favor of that. We have laws against lots of things. We have laws against drunk driving. But we're not going to ban alcohol. So where is the middle ground? Where can we take steps that will help government achieve its goals more efficiently without telling everybody what they have to do?
How seriously is this being taken at Westminster by our coalition government now, do you think?
Very seriously. I've spent the last 3 days marching around or having people parading into the Behavioral Insight team, and they are genuinely interested. I'll give you one example. There are people in the Treasury Department whose job it is to get people who owe taxes to pay their taxes. With the help of a behavioral scientist, they changed the letter they send. That has brought in hundreds of millions of pounds. Why wouldn't we do that?
Okay, on that note, we'll leave it. Richard Thurlow, thanks very much.